What's the appeal of bringing something like this to the big screen?
Oh, getting to kind of harness elements that normally aren't together for me, and that is the best sort of comic tools that you can, which is Will. And Will's a lovely actor, a great comedian, but to take that and then put with him a sense of genuine peril that you can do by having the right tools to go and photograph adventure, and in this case we have dinosaurs and we have these elements that spark my imagination as a kid, to have those collide together for a filmmaker, that's about as exciting as it gets, because it's sort of, I get to take an experience I had as a kid watching the show and now, you know, try to think, okay, time has come and gone and the audience is more sophisticated. How can we try to excite them the same way I was?
But not tamper with the memories we have of the shows as kids, right?
Yeah, well, again, somebody else might have had a different experience for me because I watched the show in first run on Saturday mornings. So what was great was, and I hadn't seen reruns of the show. I saw them back in those 3 years and that was it. So I realized that when I came on to take the movie on, I realized anything that has really stayed with me in detail this long, it's got to be in the movie and it's got to be protected. And that was from the Sleestaks on down. So when it came time to do, and I honestly did not see, and I haven't seen the second series that was done in the 90s for fear that I didn't want to, I mean, my memory was whole of the original. And so even when it came time to design the Sleestaks, I said, I want any viewer who loved that show then to be able to look at them and say, yes, that's the Sleestak, even though we were going to bring a level of detail and artistry to their creation that I don't think money and time allowed for back at that point. So that was my own goal, was let me bring these elements, protect them, and yet doesn't mean they can't exist in the environment that we want to put them in comedically and dramatically.
Now, I remember the series as being a little campy. That may not be the right word for it, but is that tone with the movie or is the tone a little different?
Well, it's funny because whatever kind of camp you remember, some of it is technical. It was, you know, a little... Yeah, if you go back and you look at any of the material now, they were doing stop motion animation with and combined with puppets. That's a pretty ballsy, only Sid Croft could do that, where suddenly you have a puppet version of a T-Rex in close-up and then cut, and he's a clay figure suddenly. I mean, they kind of went for it, and I thought, good on you. Now, when it came time to make the movie, you know, I said to Will, if we were doing a great SNL sketch, that would be fantastic for about 5 minutes. You can't do an entire film where you actually expect the audience to credibly go with a level of stakes. And so, I wouldn't say that was anything we tried to preserve, but we did take a lot of, I mean, we took lines of dialogue verbatim out of that show. Like, the first time Marshall meets Shaka, he says to him, absolutely true, he says, now Shaka, I am a doctor, but I'm not a licensed physician. Just like, where's that coming from? It's genius. So that's in the movie, when he first meets him. So we were able to play a little bit with some of that camp without having to work too hard.
No, but people who don't know the series, have never caught the reruns or anything, are they going to understand what the story is that's going on?
Yeah, it landed lost. I mean, if anything, you know, the series was sophisticated. I still think back to what they got away with. A bulk of their writing staff was from Star Trek. This was serious science fiction that I know when, I mean, I can tell you honestly that as a 9-year-old, I didn't realize it was a parallel universe. I realized that they'd gone back in time and there were these interesting pylons. I don't know that I grokked the entire sort of subtext of the sci-fi. Our story is, I think our story will be very clear. It's understandable. If anything, we get to do that thing you do in a concise 2-hour movie where you really understand the rules, the science fiction, the stakes, and then an ongoing series that's harder to do week to week. So I think it'll be pretty clear.
One last question. You just let Will go on some of the scenes, or did he stick pretty close to the script on this one?
He's interesting in that, you know, what I find with a lot of comic actors who everyone assumes are all about improv, what I love is that they really want to make sure that they've got a script as a real backboard. And so if anything, there would be moments where I found myself, he's great because he's so at ease with it from his time of the Groundlings, that you can just cue him, throw him a thought. What about, what if, boom, boom, take it, digest it while the camera's rolling. Boom, deliver it out honestly and truthfully. And so he did it, great stuff. So the film has plenty of fantastic improv in it, but it's still ultimately, it's a screenplay-based story, yeah.